Men who have seen a woman give birth, what was your thought process? Normal thoughts until the smell. It reminded me of gutting a moose. Not in a bad way, it just smelled like insides. Firstborn was 3 months after moose hunting season, which I had gotten my first. It's horrifying. It's a thing you really must do to show support to your partner and all, but whatever you do, do not cut the cord. It's like trying to hack through a blood-filled climbing rope. I cut the cord. I wasn't grossed out or anything, but the significance is overrated. I was laser focused on making my wife comfortable and helping with the process. I can't describe what was going through my mind when they finally pulled my daughter out. Just a flood of happy chemicals. Sheer bliss. I saw my wife delivering my two babies. Let me tell you, it was very traumatizing for me, seeing all the blood in her vagina open like a dragon about to eat me. But the worst thing is to see your child coming out of her. They look dead with a lot of blood without breathing. After he was out, suddenly looks alive and he is crying. At this moment I passed out. The same thing happened with the second kid. Photographer here. I love capturing images of childbirth. Everybody is too dang busy birthing a baby to be concerned about posing, so you get to capture some really raw emotions and moments. It doesn't get old, watching parents bond with this new little one. I love the messiness of it all. One of my favorite memories was getting to be in the room for a surrogate birth. The baby came early and the parents wouldn't make it to the hospital for the next morning. I had the privilege of photographing the birth for them and sending one of the images as an introduction to their son. The next morning I met them in the hospital and took photos when they got to meet him face to face. Amazing time. The harder part is that I also volunteer for an agency that provides professional photographers to take legacy portraits when a child doesn't survive. These stories cut deep and I shed tears every time I get one of these calls. I feel it is the price I have to pay though for being present for the miracle of birth in the other instances. After seeing my wife give birth, I had a new understanding of all the times in history class hearing about some woman dying in childbirth. Blood, guts, and glory. I was there for her and think that is the real reason to be there. I can't say I have been any more bonded with my child than if I had been in the waiting room. My wife though, I was there and was able to help her get through the most intense experience of her life. Really, my part was nothing more than cheering from the sidelines. The work was done all by others. But I think having the presence of a loved one helps the mother. I did cut the cord more because the doc just made it so. Put the scissors in my hand, put the cord in the scissors and told me to squeeze, so really didn't have a choice. Wasn't too keen on doing so myself. It is an odd experience. Having been a hospital patient plenty of times, let me tell you that having someone there to look after you, the person instead of you, the patient, is indescribably helpful. My ex-wife attempted to go natural and then we had to go C-section midway through, as we later found out my son's arm was raised over his head, obstructing his path out of the womb. I would recommend not being distracted by the significance of the events, the real-time graphic images, or the other people in the room. Our doctor was very hesitant to do the C-section. The doctor said he had been in the pathway too long and could be problematic, yet still wasn't doing anything to solve it. She was either too calm or it was paralysis by analysis. I'm still not sure. Keep a level head, support your woman, and carefully listen to what the doctors are saying, and that it adds up. I will never know whether our doctor was a dingus or had a reason to wait. I forced the C-section and I am happy I did it, as my son is healthy as can be today. Oh Jesus. It's as slippery as it looks. How do people not drop these things every time? Why do they think letting the father pull the baby out is a good idea? Hugh. Got it onto her belly. There's no way that was safe. Oh great, they gave me scissors. Don't cut his dong off. Don't cut his dong off. Okay, I cut the cord. Is he still a boy? Yes. My husband doesn't comment, but I asked him and he shrugged and said, "Here she comes." He is a wonderfully simple man. I was there when my daughter was born over 34 years ago in 1982. The umbilical cord was wrapped around her neck and it took a little while for her to come out. When she was finally born, my heart was beating out of my chest as I waited for her to cry, because she was a little blue-gray looking thing. I'll never forget how I felt the first time I heard that cry. I don't remember being freaked out by the blood or placenta or anything like that, just real glad to finally hold my daughter. the mother of my godson. My thoughts were, woman, you're crushing my hand. I should have made you trim your fingernails. They are drawing blood. Whoa, you are doing so well. How is a 17-year-old going to be able to cope by herself? How is her body not splitting in half as this kid is huge? You are a truly amazing person. I'm going to track the father of this kid down and beat the crap out of him again. Keep squeezing my hand, honey. I think you've broken it anyway, but I'll cry and faint later. He's out. Sure, I'll cut the cord, although at the same time you. Why are you smacking him around and where are you taking him? Seeing what just happened to your vajaja is worse than watching my favorite pub burning down. I hope it gets better. He's back. He's healthy. He's amazing. And you're amazing. Holy frick 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 frick. I just want to say that you are an awesome human being for being with her during that time. I watched my wife give birth twice. I'm not real squeamish, so I found it pretty fascinating. It's surprising what the human body can do and recover from. Here's something they don't really prepare you for. Your baby looks fricked up. Like, Nosferatu turning around fricked up. Pale. Squashed. Bug eyes. Weird expression. Covered in goo. No joke, I had thought my daughter was a mutant. I thought she was physically deformed or handicapped. For a split second I was terrified. Then they laid her on my wife, wiped her off, and she looked like a normal baby. Thank God. I may be different than most fathers here, in that it was a C-section. Weirdly enough, because it was an actual surgery instead of a natural birth, I saw far less blood and guts than others. They took her back first, got her prepped and drugged, then brought me back. I sat by her head while they did the dirty work, and then I heard the baby cry. The only thing I heard from my wife was that she felt a weird tugging. No pain, just the different parts of her body, internal and external, being pulled around as they were cutting and or shifting things. After the baby had her initial checks, weight, breathing, heart, they wrapped her up and sent us out of the room so they could close up. So I guess I missed out on the movie TV show Scream Cry Sessions, but I'm pretty okay with that. Seriously? Ugh. Closely followed by how can anyone who loves their wife put them through that kind of pain? Woman with no children here. Mom and I were on the business end when my sister gave birth. First thing, I could believe how much your junk swells. Like, whoa. I mean, we've discussed our labia before, and I'm pretty sure ours are pretty similar, so I don't think she normally looks like it. I don't even know how to describe it, but everything down there was much bigger than normal. Seeing the baby crown was simultaneously one of the most horrendous and amazing things I've ever witnessed. Just, ugh. The nurse used her fingers to, like, rub the lower vagina back and forth while we were waiting, and then you could just see the top of her head. Pretty sure that's what I started crying. I'll grant you, the process is disgusting, but the end result is freaking beautiful. After months and months of waiting and preparing, you get to see this new human being enter the world. I used my brother-in-law's phone to make an audio recording at the very end, and hearing the first wail from my niece makes me tear up every time. The afterbirth though, shudders. Will say though, I'm definitely getting the epidural if it's ever my turn. TLDR. I wonder if the nurse knows she's still wearing her smartwatch. Oh, that's a lot of fluid. I better save that watch. My girlfriend was in labor last year, and we were very near the end of it all. The doctor was dealing with multiple deliveries at once, so he was out of the room when my GF has another huge contraction. The only nurse in the room reacted very quickly, thank God, and got into position under her just in time for my daughter's head to come out. Though not in time to actually prepare, she caught my daughter with only one latex glove on and wasn't even able to call the doctor in. As I'm watching this poor nurse react to the sudden burst of baby and afterbirth from my GF, I happened to focus on the fact that she also didn't have a chance to take off her Apple Watch. So I went over and took it off her wrist while she pulled my daughter out of my girlfriend. She was very, very grateful. Everything was perfectly fine in the end. Healthy mom, daughter, and a clean watch. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Push, honey. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Push, honey. Repeat 3 or 4 more times. Pop, tears of joy to follow. I just gave birth to our youngest a month ago. My husband wholeheartedly agrees with your comment. for me it kind of became a quick nightmare. Let me explain. She was in labor already for 24 hours. She tried with all her might, but our firstborn was being stubborn. I was outside talking to her brother, as she asked to see her mom cause she was scared. Totally understood, we were only 18. Doctors said I had to leave because he didn't want to crowd the room and figure she would like a quick break before she went back at it. Next thing I know, her mom is running out saying I needed to go back as they were prepping her for surgery. What? I sprint down the hall unsure what are going on and she isn't there. Gathering our stuff, a nurse comes and grabs me and hands me some zip-up cloth hazmat suits to put on quickly. She was needing an emergency cesarean as her hips were too little and our son got stuck. I'm freaking out at this point cause I don't know what all that means. I walk in and quickly calm my fiancé who is getting loopy on the drugs. She keeps asking me what's going on. I'm trying to give her cliff notes. And before I knew it, they were pulling my baby boy up and out and laid him down, start cleaning him up. Honestly, a million things going through my mind. I'm in tears telling her he's beautiful and she is so drugged up saying he looks just like me even though she hasn't seen him. Finally, after what felt forever, heard his cry start to gain strength. They quickly escorted me out though as they had to stop the bleeding, so I was alone in a room with my child waiting for an answer. It honestly was scary as frick. The baby's head was crowing and I thought to myself, there's no way that head is going to fit through her vagina. It did. I intentionally stayed by wife's side and held her hand through the birth of both of our kids instead of watching the action down below. I love my wife. I love my wife's vagina. I didn't want that image to forever be imprinted in my mind when thinking about her perfect vagina for the rest of our lives. Saw my twin boys delivered at 7 months via C-section. It was the most horrific thing I've ever seen. Seeing them pull babies out of a hole that they've cut into your wife's abdomen was hard to watch. It was a difficult pregnancy, and one baby was much smaller than the other. When they took out the big baby first, I was really hoping that he was the small one. He was not. No baby, no baby, no baby, no bee. Holy shit, her head is coming out of her VWO and there's the rest of the baby. Holy crap, that was amazing. As a daddy of 5, I've seen my share. However, nothing about it has been gross, etc. My wife had a uterine inversion with our first that caused her to lose a lot of blood and get rushed to the OR to fix things. Through all of it, all that had been important is the health and safety of my wife and kiddos. My wife went through all of them without meds and rocked it. I guess I get so caught up with everything happening that all of the other stuff, blood, poop, is irrelevant. My wife was giving birth with no anesthesia. She had missed her window, so she had no choice but to do it the old-fashioned way. It was our first kid, so we were nervous already. Hearing her in so much pain scared me more than I've ever been scared in my life. It honestly seemed like she was being tortured. The nurses weren't very nice either. They took a short tone with her, asking her if she had taken breathing classes. They sounded almost accusatory. Then the doctor told the nurses they had to pull out my son. I swear, the second he was born and started crying, it was like all the pain for my wife had vanished. It was incredible. She was so at peace. They rested him on her chest and he began breastfeeding. It's one of the most beautiful things I have ever seen. I saw my wife give birth. Of course, it was gross with the stretching and blood and all, but at the same time it was beautiful, as it was a life being born. I cut the cord too. It wasn't bad. My ex-husband, after I gave birth, told one of his co-workers that he felt bad when I was in labor because he knew I was in an incredible amount of pain and could do absolutely nothing to help me. My husband said with our first, he walked into the operating room, C-section, and saw my body open. He can watch gore and stuff like that, but he said that was too much. I didn't know much about what goes on during C-sections at the time, but he saw my intestines among other things. The second time, he knew to look to the side when he walked in. He didn't really see as much as the first. Painful, peculiar, awesome and gross, but not all that special gory extreme that people make it up to be. I've seen mammals give a birth. It is a quite normal bodily process that usually goes just fine. So I wasn't grossed by it, mainly found it peculiar and reminder of our fleshiness. And she handled it well. In pain. It was right that coming from line of easy birthers, nowhere near the horror shall people seem to make it to be, and all kinds of awesome. On my first daughter I watched being born. 37 years ago, the doctor decided my wife needed an episiotomy, a surgical cut made at the opening of the vagina during childbirth, to aid a difficult delivery and prevent rupture of tissues. They stitch it up afterwards. He picked up the scissors, made the snip, turned a bit to put the scissors down, and he turned back around in time to literally catch my daughter in midair as she shot out of my wife. Good hands, doc. My son is a medical student. Right now, he is going through his internship in the OB section of the hospital. During his first turn, he had to help with the delivery right away. He was horrified. The mother tore and there was a lot of blood coming out. He was instructed by the doctor to push here and there to bring out the liquid, and look at the placenta. Feel this, is a woman's uterus. Now, don't drop the baby. He was so horrified by women's body during that first week that he claimed that he's asexual now. LOL. He played for 1 hour with my boobs and forgot about that. Watching my son's face emerge was transformative. Whatever my life had been up to that point, whatever had been my goals and aspirations, simply ceased to exist. From that point on, the purpose of my life had been given over to this mysterious little face. Every man should be present at childbirth. It's a profound experience. If it's your child that is being born, there is honestly no way to describe the rush of instantaneous love that overcomes you when you see your child for the first time. It is unlike anything I have ever felt before. When my second child was born, I didn't think it was possible to feel that way again, but I was wrong. I was pretty traumatized when we had our first child. Couldn't believe what I saw. Couldn't have sex for a few months just because I was in shock. Not so much with my second child. We'll be having our first in February. My husband is under the impression that once you've seen help deliver hogs, sheep, rabbits, goats, cats, dogs, etc., this is likely not going to look too terribly different. Well, that experience is why my grandmother lived. Her father was a sheep farmer and the midwife had died in a horrible accident. She's coming along breech and he's the only option. He got her out and got her breathing. Saved his wife too. So yeah, he's not entirely wrong. It's nowhere near as clean as the movies suggest. There's a lot of fluids and weird smells. It's amazing, but it's not beautiful. I was terrified because it was my wife it was happening to. She was cut open. Two of our three kids were born via caesarean, and there was really nothing I could do to help other than encourage her. I was confused. It was very bright and cold, then a giant picked me up by my ankles and hit me on the butt, so I screamed and urinated on him. Been there for all four of my children. Every time is very emotional for me. The mother's pain. The excitement of meeting a brand new person. All exaggerated from the lack of food or rest. It's hard to describe, but I'll try. Imagine watching Santa flying towards your house in his magical sleigh only to be hit by a crop dusting plane and then falling to what must be his fiery death, losing limbs, and blood by the gallon. And when his body meets the earth, after lying there motionless, his mangled carcass suddenly begins to move. He continues crawling to you, inch by agonizing inch, carrying the one present you've wanted for your entire life while you stand there with a glazed look on your face, unable to help. Unable to breath and your hands outstretched waiting to receive. Like that, but worse. My hubby explains my vaginal as watching his favorite pub burn down. He explains my section as medically amazing and extremely gruesome. I got to see your insides. It's a very professional atmosphere. I know that may sound obvious, but I was concerned I was going to be weirded out. However, everything is down to business, and I didn't think I would cry, but man, when that baby came out I started bawling. Partially crying because my wife worked so hard and kicked butt. Like really, women put everything they have into pushing the baby out. I was proud of her and relieved as well. The epidermal is kind of scary. Not every day you get a giant needle through your spine either. To see that go smoothly was great as well. Much of the rest of the time you're so busy annoyed time flies by and you're home before you know it. I would love to thank God and fate and chanced randomness of the specific chromosomes for not giving me a vagina and not bleeding every month and not have a human burst out of my body at some point in my life. TL. DR. My wife had to have an emergency C-section due to preeclampsia after 36 weeks. It was terrifying and beautiful, and it still makes me emotional when I think about it. We had no indication that anything was wrong, but 4 weeks before her due date I received a voicemail at work. I step out of my meeting and check it. My wife is having serious issues with her blood pressure. She's having trouble seeing and is at the emergency room. And I have 2 hours at rush hour to get to the Bay Area from Sacramento. If I don't get there, then I'm going to miss seeing my daughter being born. My sister-in-law calls me and tells me she's on her way to pick me. I quickly make arrangements and we race down to the hospital. I arrive in time to find my wife being pumped full of magnesium to control her blood pressure and quickly dress in scrubs and get into the delivery room. The epidural didn't work, so they had to give her something else. They waited for it to work. And then I'm told if there is any complication I need to stay away from the table. We quickly discuss what happens if my daughter is underweight and how I would leave my wife and follow my daughter into the NICU. They make the incision. There is a ton of blood and maneuvering of my wife's belly, and my daughter is breech born and underweight. If the circumstances had been slightly different, I could have lost both of them, but I didn't, and I'm a happy stay-at-home dad. Three kids here. First was the most medically invasive, epidural for my wife, which sucked. Vacuum assisted delivery, healthy baby girl. Second was a planned water birth, no meds, wife was a rock star, healthy boy. Third just a few months ago, planned water birth again, no meds, second son born on the bed due to some crazy timing issues. Fastest birth thus far. During all three, I remember having a new respect for what women go through during all this. Also, and fully against normal Reddit standards, as a Christian, seeing childbirth just cemented my belief in God. Hard to explain, really. Oh, the smell. No one warns you about the smell. Just don't puke. Keep it together, you pansy. We have two little ones. Both times, it was only adrenaline and repeating to myself not to drop a leg while she was pushing. Jeez, those forceps are a lot bigger than I remember. Dang, they are really jamming them in there. Huh, blood splashing all over. I need to sit down. Oh, thank God he's out. First child. I hope she is okay. 14-hour labor. Had to pull my 10 pounds daughter out of my 5 feet 4 inches wife with a suction device. I was very upset, and my wife ripped. Second child. New wife. Son was coming out face up versus down. They had to do an episiotomy. It looked like cutting chicken. My wife didn't appreciate that. Third child. Easy peasy. In all cases, I was in awe of my wife's ability to handle pain. Didn't know the gender of any of my kids until they were born. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.